What up? Thank you guys for joining in today. I am BK, back with another banger. So, I'm going to keep this one really short, as short as I can. But I just got off the phone with Akai. I'm not going to name the representative. He's a nice guy. He seemed like he was trying to help. In the conversation was based around Elastic Pro and the Keygroups. And why is it buffering and causing CPU spikes when all I have is one sample in a Keygroup, right? I'm not going to go into the full-on details with the conversation. It was brief. Again, the gentleman was nice. But he said, what you need to do is resample the sounds and then bring them back into a Keygroup. And I'm like, and he's using all these technical jargon, talking fast to get off the phone, basically, right? That's how I took it. If that's not how it was, that's how I interpreted it. He said, hold on, let me find the best source. So he emails me this video, a video that I've already seen in the past, right? About resampling stuff that I teach on my channel on how to do, right? So when he said resample, I'm like, I know what he mean by resample, but he can't be, why would I take a one shot sample, right? One sound, put it in a Keygroup to resample that sound. Make that make sense, right? Make that make sense to me. So I'm not gonna play this brother's video, Drum Machine Addict. Salute to them. You guys could check them out if you choose to. But let's get over into the MPC. All right, so we here in the MPC, and I'm gonna try to make this as quick as possible, right? The audio warp and BPM detect. It's currently on Elastic Pro Best Sound. Elastic Pro Best Sound eats up a lot of your CPU. I have a 16 gig RAM computer, Mac Pro. It's an old MacBook Pro, but it still gets the job done, okay? When you're sampling and you're stretching the audio and you're on MPC Lee CPU, when you're pitching the sounds or doing any type of time stretch, it's not pleasant. It's not what you're going for. It's not the same as in Studio One. It's not the same as in Ableton, right? You guys put Elastic Pro here, so it's supposed to be the best one for you to use to the capacity of your setup. If you have 16 gigs, it's gonna go to the cap. If you have 8 gigs, it's gonna go to the cap. You got 32, 64, 128, so on and so forth. Whatever your capacity is of your memory, your RAM, that's what it's gonna work with. I have 16 gigs, all right? With the screen capturing software, the MPC opened up, I have 7.1 gigabytes available of memory out of my 16. And it's teetering between 7 and 16. It just dropped to 6.99 while I'm on camera. There's nothing going on. The MPC is spiking and there's nothing being played. So to this Keygroup that I'm working on, right? I have this. It's gonna buffer crazy when I press play. Well, it didn't buffer crazy that time because why? I didn't have the warp on. So I'm gonna play it again without the warp. Warp on. So for the guy at Akai who told me, right, that I should take this one sample right here, do what they showed here, which is to resample a drum program with drums on it, add it to a pad, right? So you bounce this, right? You bounce the sequence. So I'm supposed to bounce this chord progression, right? I got this chord progression going on. I bounce it by export audio. These are the instructions, right? That not the guy from Akai told me, but he suggested someone on YouTube to tell me this is what I should do, which is something that I know that I've already taught, right? But okay, I gave him the benefit of the doubt. So after I bounce it and I drag it down here, see, sample already exists. I'm gonna cancel that. This is what it becomes. So if I were not sound designing a key group to play on any beat, any production that I'm using, right? This wouldn't have been a thing, right? If I was using this in a beat, it would have been fine. No problem. Bounce the sample, bring it back in on a pad, chop it up, play it how I want to play it, if that's what I was doing. But that is not what I was doing. And instead of the technician at Akai asking me, so what are you trying to do? What is it that you're wanting to accomplish? No, it goes into you're the consumer, you're the customer. I'm the guy behind the phone at the desk with the title technician. So this is what it is. You're using too much samples. You have a one-shot sample inside of you have a one-shot sample inside of your key group that you're designing, and you're using too many key groups. Where in the manual that Akai do not provide willingly, you gotta search for it, for that they state that, first of all, you could have up to 128 number of key groups. 128. So by me having a measly 10, right? Type back in 10, I'm doing too much. But me having a 10 out of 128, if it's designed to go all the way to 128, and it's also designed for the sample layers to have four different samples layered, where does it state that you shouldn't use more than he didn't say you shouldn't use more than, he said you should use a minimum amount. You know, you should resample and use a minimum amount. Like, make that make sense. That's my rant for the day. I'm going to edit this down and send it to the representative of Akai, as well as place it on the channel so the world can see. And Akai, you guys just need to do better. I'm not here to tear the company down. I'm one person, right? I'm not here to tear the company down, and I'm not here to send out false news nor false information. But if I spent my money, hard-earned money, on a product, I want the product to perform like the product performed. You know what his comparison to me was? It's like you go into an ATM to withdraw $2,000 from an ATM that can only give you $100 at a time, and you're trying to pull out the $2,000. As much as that may sound like it makes sense, in this situation, it makes no sense whatsoever. Okay? The key groups are designed for you to put in a sample, put in whatever you're gonna put into it, and It's right here in your face. You can sample layers. I can put as many sample layers as I think or feel that I want to, up to four of them, right? I'm supposed to be able to do that because it's here in the software on the MPC. It's there for you. Like I'm not stepping out of bounds. I'm not coming outside of the lines. I'm doing nothing out of the ordinary. There's nothing on the inserts. I have these inserts here because I'm sound designing. So I'm testing. I'm looking for the key range. I need this to be here in order for me to work. Right? Man, I'm so upset because this is wasting time. Like, it's just wasting time. By me recording this, I'm recording it really to send to Akai, but I'm sharing it with the community as well, because you guys need to get on top of them as well. Because you're coming to me, I'm doing customer service for Akai, and I'm not getting paid by that. And I guess I signed up for that because I do tutorials, but at the same time, it's like, yo, like, if I don't know and I call you to ask you and you're sending me to someone on YouTube to do something that's non-relevant to what I'm doing, sir, what, why? Enough of that. So basically, this is the situation. Once you get up into the higher octaves, it's not performing like it should, right? So this is octave 3. I'm in pad performance mode. Once I press warp, you automatically see in the spikes in the CPU, right? I go up the octave. Now, when I press play, oh, and that's the other thing. The other thing is that this doesn't work when you're in any other mode. You have to be in program edit in order for the warp function to work. That's another situation that Akai needs to look into. All right. That should not be a thing, all right? If I'm in Studio One and I'm using any other sampler, that's not a thing. So I don't understand. I'm like, just make that make sense for me. I'm not gonna say your name, sir, but if you get to this part of the video once I send it to you, please make that make sense to me. And why did you tell me to bounce it to sample? Why did you tell me to do that? For this? What am I doing with that inside of a key group, sir? Do remember that music is life. It is our DNA. Keep banging. Peace, love, and light. Till next time. Hopefully, my next one will be less ranting. All right? Love and light. Peace.